Natural disasters, hurricanes, tornadoes, earthquakes, forest fires, tsunamis. Seems like every 5 minutes there's another one. Leading us to the inevitable question, why? Why does God make this happen? A lot of people are asking that question right now. And some people are coming up with some crazy answers. Like Reverend Pat Robertson, he explained the earthquake that happened in Haiti a few years back. Remember that massive earthquake that happened there? He said, well, it's because Haiti is so full of sinners and God is punishing them. That's bull. In fact, it's worse than just bull. This is what the church would call a heresy, because we're denying the unconditional love of God and suggesting that God is out to see a bunch of innocent children suffer for the sins of others. God doesn't cause natural disasters. The reality is there are a lot of things that happen in this world that are not God's will. War, child abuse, global poverty, and yes, natural disasters. Not God's will. Even though insurance companies to this day refer to earthquakes, hurricanes, lightning strikes, and pianos falling from the sky as acts of God. These are not acts of God. From the God of Israel, the God of Jesus, it isn't God that throws down lightning bolts. That was somebody else that threw down lightning bolts. That was Zeus. And he doesn't exist. So, while it may be true that other world religions, other ancient mythologies, believe that natural disasters were caused by the gods, that is not our tradition. That's not the Judeo-Christian tradition. Okay, fine. But natural disasters are still happening. What's up with that? God still permits them to take place, doesn't he? He still lets them happen. God is in control of everything. He has the ability to stop a natural disaster from happening, so why doesn't he? If God can do anything, why doesn't he stop earthquakes and hurricanes and volcanoes from killing lots of people, from leaving people homeless, from destroying civilizations? Why doesn't he? Why? There's the question. Why? It's a very human thing to do, to ask the question, why? Especially when things happen that don't make sense to us. Why do bad things happen to good people? Why can't I do this, such and such? Why are things the way they are? Sometimes searching for the answer to the question why leads us to deeper truths, to things about the universe, leads to scientific progress, leads us to realize things about the universe that we didn't realize before. But sometimes we reach the scariest possibility of them all. Sometimes we can't find an answer to the question, why? Because there is no answer.
But tell me why I can't.
No, there is no why.
We want for there to be an answer to the question, why? Why did this happen? Because if we can figure it out, we can maybe prevent it from happening again. And then we're in control. But sometimes we can't. Sometimes that sense of security that we seek so badly will elude us. Sometimes there is no control. We need to face the terrifying reality that the universe we live in, that God has apparently placed us in, is chaotic, random, scary. Sometimes we'll be living our lives happily, and randomly, our planet will collide with another planet, and we're gone. There's no why, just because, that's all. Jesus, hanging on his cross, called out to his Father and asked, why? Why have you forsaken me? Why is this happening to me? He felt abandoned. He felt alone, like God had left him. Probably not unlike the way those people who suffer because of natural disasters feel. Perhaps right now. But as my old rector at the seminary, Father Jean Papin, used to say, what Jesus does on the cross is he turns his why have you forsaken me, into a how. How to accept the suffering that life keeps giving us in life. To turn it into an act of faith that God's creative power is somehow going to transcend and redeem the destruction that's evident all around us. And turn it into a passageway, into an even better place, into new life. Jesus, why have you forsaken me? Becomes, into your hands I commend my spirit. So maybe like Yoda says,
why? Why? There is no why.
It's a human quality to always want to know why. Sometimes there is no why in this world. Face it. But God can redeem the tragedy, can redeem the thousand tragedies. Tragedy awakens the humanity in us. Humanity that sometimes has been lulled asleep by our complacency, by how easy life has been up to us up to that point. Tragedy can awake the compassion in us. It can bring out the best in us. Sometimes in tragedy, people didn't care about each other yesterday, but today, they're taking care of each other. Now, that compassion, that's not the reason why God would cause the natural disaster. But there could be ways that God will take those thousand tragedies that take place in a natural disaster and turn them into opportunities to create, to love, to be like Him, like God, who is love. Amen. If you want to help those who are suffering from the natural disaster right now, just contact the Red Cross. They're a trustworthy organization, and your money will get to the people who need it.